So, if you see under preferential allotment, as we discussed now, preferential allotment is that you're going to do to a few people. Okay, so instead of going to the public for subscription, so instead of that, you're going to get your funds quickly in the form of making preferential allotment. So, in order to increase your share capital, okay, so if you want to expand your business to the next level, your company to the next level, or if you want to engage in new projects, that time if you want additional funds means, so instead of going to the public for subscription and involving a lot of steps, SEBI guidelines, everything you have to adapt there. So, instead that no, you just want to raise your funds quickly so that you can continue your operations without any disturbance or stoppage like that. So you want to do it up quickly so you can find out the best way that you can make preferential allotment. So this will be done to a few people. Okay, so they are ready to contribute funds to your company means then you can make to those people as preferential allotment. So preferential means you're going to give priority to a few people and you can allot shares. So private placement also usually we interchange these two terms. There is one more term, as I said, public issue, rights issue, preferential allotment, and then private placement. One term called private placement is there. So private placement means if I am going to offer shares, no, I am going to make an invite. I'm going to invite people. Okay, so they can be bank or financial institutions like that. They can be, and I am going to invite that people. I'm going to offer my company shares so that they can get. So like that, if I'm going to place shares before people, I'm going to invite them. Okay, I'm going to offer them. So that is known as private placement. But preferential allotment means I'm going to allot shares itself. Okay, so there is difference between private place preferential allotment. Certain differences is there. Both since we think no, it is like unique only. But even then, they had got some difference. What is that? So some banks or financial institutions, I'm just going to, or few wealthy investors, I'm just going to call them. I'm going to offer them. I'm going to invite the people. Okay. But preferential allotment is that I'm going to allot the shares itself. So to the few people there. Okay. So instead of going for the entire public so for subscription fund mobilization purpose, I'm going to just go to the few people and I'm going to allot shares to them. Okay, so allotment itself done in under in case of preferential allotment. But private placement, I'm just going to offer that I'm in mood of selling shares to the public. So if you are interested, you can get shares like that. If I'm going for few wealthy investors, industrial people like that, or banks or some financial institutions, then that is known as private placement. But here I'm going to give priority to certain people and I'm going to allot shares to them itself. So that is known as preferential allotment, and it is considered as the quickest method of getting fund mobilization. Okay, so what all the companies can do the preferential allotment? It can be a public company, private company, listed company, unlisted company. So under Section 8 of Companies Act, no, they can go in for preferential allotment. What kind of securities can be done under preferential allotment? Okay, equity shares, as I told, shares are of two types. One is equity shares, other one is preference shares. Okay, so preferentially you have many other types also. So equity shares means they will take part in the company activities and voting power, everything is there. Control power, everything, ownership right, everything is there. But only when other people's commitment, everything is going off, then only their profit or return will come to them. Okay, but preference shares, other people know, debentures know, they will be first met. Okay, so as in our home, immediately after our salary is getting credited, first we will pay EMI, and then what are the essential things we pay, and then we will be going for the entertainment, other thing. So like that, if a company is enjoying profit, no, first it will go to the debenture holders. The company, they have to pay interest. EMI every interest we are paying regularly. Similarly, you have to pay the debenture holders interest. So then preference shareholders dividend, everything will be finally only equity shareholders returns will be given to them. Okay, if the company desires, wishes to give, then only they will be giving. Okay, so like that, what all the securities can be done under preferential allotment means equity shares, fully convertible debentures, partly convertible debentures, debentures, as I told already, debentures means you have to pay them interest. They also will provide fund to the company. Our shareholders providing fund, debenture holders will provide fund, but they will be getting interest. The year shareholders means they will be getting dividend. Debenture holders means they will be getting interest. So fully convertible debentures means at a certain point of time, no, debentures can be converted into equity shares. It's all depends, okay? Debentures can... certain debentures can be converted after a certain period of time, after a number of years, can be converted either into equity shares, preference shares, like that. Okay, so fully convertible debentures, partly convertible debentures, na adha artham. Okay, so you can, after a certain number of years, no, a part of the debentures can be converted into equity shares. Okay, so fully convertible means entire amount, whatever the debentures they have, they hold 1,000 debentures means entire thing they can convert into shares. Okay, so like that. So in this any kind of securities, no, you can make the preferential allotment. Okay, so what is this preferential allotment? If you see, so you are going to give certain priority for a person, which is not exclusively for the already existing members. If you are going to do it up for existing shareholders, then it is rights issue. Existing shareholders, okay, number 3B shares, if you are going to offer, means that is known as rights issue. But preferential allotment is that you're going to exclusively give to certain people. Okay, so to certain people, you're going to allot shares. So that is known as preferential allotment. So this will surely increase your number of members in your company, number of shareholders in your company. Because in rights issue, no, already existing shareholders ke nama 3B shares issue panumbodhu, so their control ownership avungalukke dhan 3B pogudhu. So and members also will remain the same. Already if the company is having 500 shareholders or members, then rights issue if I am making means 500 members only will be there, because avungalukke shares I am going to issue. But preferential allotment is I'm going to exclusively issue for certain other people. So the number of members can increase. There is a chances of increasing in the number of members in the company. They are going to get priority. So ownership right controls and everything might get changed in the company. Okay, so it can be in that way. Okay, so procedures for preferential allotment, what all things can should be done in case of if you are going for preferential allotment. So public issue, everything you have procedure provisions under Companies Act. If you are going to make rights issue, if you are going to make public issue, if you are going to make preferential allotment, for everything you have to follow the guidelines which has been given under the Companies Act. Okay, so you have to convene a meeting, board meeting, and you have to send a notice to the people. And then you have to pass a resolution. You have to contact all the shareholders who are there. No, they have to approve, right? So already their shareholders, their internal control, ownership, everything, they have to think over. Their returns from the company in future, everything they also want to think over. So all the shareholders, already existing shareholders, should approve that. They have to conduct a meeting for that. Extraordinary general meeting, everything they have to conduct. They have to fix a date, time, everything for that. When it has to be conducted, that extraordinary general meeting, all the shareholders should attend. They should approve. Okay, then only they can pass the resolution. Okay, and then in case of if they are going to make preferential allotment under which bank, because initially while collecting the application money, every transaction will be done through bank account only. Okay, so which person we have to appoint and who should be the banker for that? How we are going to collect the money, receive money from the person, from the people? So everything has to be decided earlier. Okay, so that has to be communicated, the resolution has to be passed, everything has to be, whatever proceedings, everything we have to even communicate to the registrar of companies. You have to communicate that, okay, to whom you are going to allot, make allotment, everything we have to dispatch properly. Okay, because you will be having share certificate, everything here. Okay, so if you are going to, how if you are making FD deposit, you are getting that receipt. Similar way, if you are going to buy shares of a company, you will be getting a receipt that is known as share certificate. So that will tell you you have got right in that company. Okay, so you have got this number of shares, this person is holding in this company. So it's like it will give you the authority or the it will give the ownership right in that company actually. So everything has to be decided. If you are going in for preferential allotment, how to allot the shares, to whom we have to allot the shares, and before allotting the shares, we have to conduct the board meeting, extraordinary general meeting, all the shareholders, directors, all those people, already existing members should approve that. They have to pass a special resolution for that purpose, and everything they have to communicate to the registrar of companies, and then how you are going to collect the amount from the person, whom will be the banker for that. So everything has to be done. Okay, so so after the board meeting resolution, everything they have passed, within that 60 days they have to do all the procedures, and they have to allot the shares to the concerned person, and they have to communicate everything to the registrar of companies actually. Okay, so what are the enclosures they have to have in case of if they are going to make some preferential allotment? What are the things to be done? They have to pass a resolution by the members of the company in annual general meeting or extraordinary general meeting, as the case may be. So if it is an annual general meeting, they can pass the resolution, or annual general meeting, it takes some time to be conducted. Means in case of that extraordinary general meeting, if organized, then they have to pass the resolution. They have to report to the registrar of companies, everything they have to done, it has to get done. Okay, so you have to allot the securities to the shareholders, and within 15 days that return of allotment should be filed within 15 days to the registrar of companies. Okay, to whom we have allotted the shares. Okay, what special resolution you have passed, what are the things that special resolution contains actually, that explanatory statement, everything has to be communicated to the registrar of companies. So whatever the communication, everything, whatever the meeting you organize or resolution you pass, everything has to be conveyed to the registrar office, registrar of companies, where your business is situated actually. Everything has to be given information about your members, about your directors, everything, it has to be given. So similarly, if you are going to make for a preferential allotment, you have to give that special resolution, whatever you have passed, that one you have to send, and whom you have allotted the shares, everything, it has to be communicated. Okay, so if you have issued shares for cash other than for cash, okay, so all those things you have to intimate. You must have a proper record and report of that actually. Okay, so from this, if you see, you must know what is meant by preferential allotment. Okay, so preferential allotment is that, so instead of raising funds from the direct public, you are going to allot shares to few people, few individuals, so that you can get mobilize your funds quickly. Okay, so that is the major benefit you get. Because instead of going on undergoing lot of process and following lot of rules and regulations, and it takes time. So if you going to allot to some people who are interested to give funds to your business, you can just allot them, and you have to follow the guidelines, rules for that. which has been provided under the Companies Act actually. Okay, so which kind of securities can be given for preferential allotment? And this is that you are not going to give for existing shareholders. If you are going for existing shareholders, means then it is known as rights issue. If you are going direct to the public, then it is known as public issue. But you are going for to few people. You are going to just prioritize to whom we can allot the shares so that we can get quickly. So in that way, you are going to just do it up so that you can get fund for your business, whatever you are requiring, that financial support you can get quickly for your business. Okay, so procedures that are involved, you must know. Okay, so what the business and board of directors, what they have to do, step by step procedures, how they are going to make allotment, to whom they are going to make allotment, and how they are going to conduct meeting and pass resolution. Everything should be included under procedures or the steps involved in preferential allotment. Any